The next session is by a digisitare. We are pleased to introduce to you our first digisitare, Ms. Lavanya Misala. Ms. Lavanya is currently working in FCC department, HPG RDC, Bengaluru. She has an overall experience of 13 years in various domains of oil and gas R&D, process design and operations. She is handling technology development for HCNG and H2 production with low CO2 footprint and biomass to fuels as major research projects. Her topic of presentation today is white space analysis using AI-enabled digital database.
A very good evening to all of you. I'm Lavanya Misala. I'm working as a researcher at HP Green R&D Center, Bangalore. At the outset, I would like to thank Team Parikalp for giving me this opportunity to present our journey on white space analysis using AI-enabled digital database. Next. Before going into the details of what is white space analysis and how it is evolved as an innovation pathway, I would like to give a brief background of how it has developed into an idea. Way back in 2019, all our researchers at HP Green R&D Center were posed with a question: as a young scientist, how do you perceive innovation is? And what are the hidden truths of innovation behind a very successful R&D organizations? And do we have any gaps existing at that moment of time? And what is the action plan to go forward about it? As a part of this exercise, as my contribution, I have proposed white space analysis as one of the innovation theme, and which was further developed into the innovation pathways as one of the pathway among almost 28 innovation pathways which are being followed at HPGRDC currently. Now, to know what is white space analysis, by definition, white space analysis is a methodology that identifies the absence of patents in a particular area, which acts as a driver of innovation decision making. When we are talking about the patents, it is very important to know that as a commercial R&D organization, for one organization to protect its developed technologies or the formulations not being copied by others without any license fee, one has to file very actively the patents into that particular domain. And a patent is a territorial right, so that means it is actually you have to file it in a different regions like India, Europe and USA at a different patent offices. And as a prerequisite, one has to give a prior art. What is prior art existing in that particular area of technology? For giving the prior art information, one has to know about in-depth knowledge about the patents belonging to a particular domain of that particular technology, and what are the gaps existing over there, and how my research solution is going to be having a competitive edge than the existing ones. And another aspect of doing a white space analysis or a patent landscape analysis is an incremental innovation. Why we are talking about incremental innovation here is like in India, like we are having a lot many new technologies being deployed across various sectors, and some of them are actually being licensed by the foreign licenses. So there is a very good need and cause, like we need to develop our own technologies and give importance to the indigenization. To go towards the indigenized technologies, first we need to know what are the existing technologies features are and how well they are protected, and what kind of research I can conduct that I can have a competitive edge over and above the existing technologies. And also as a HPCL, we are not only being an oil and gas industry, we are expanding our wings into a lot of new energy sectors like a bio, solar and other alternative energy sectors. So it is very important to know what is the information out there existing on this future potential research areas, and how we can gear up ourselves to kind of conduct active research into that and provide our own contributions there. So by conducting this whole white space analysis or a patent landscape analysis, one would be able to highlight what are the crowded and the sparse areas in that particular white space, in that particular domain. And after identifying the space areas, as a researcher, it is my knowledge base, from my knowledge base and the expertise, I should be able to put up an explanation why a certain development has not taken place into that area. Is it a technology reason or the commercial viability or else there is a chemistry wise it is not a feasible solution at all. So this is very important information and aspect what is going to be added by the researcher to come up with their effective research proposal. Now we know what is the importance of white space analysis and why it has to be conducted. But how we need to do is like either we can go with the conventional way of going to Google Patents, which is having a risk of using open resource, whereas R&D center like us who work on confidential research, it has a risk of a confidentiality breach, and as well as it will not be providing us a comprehensive analysis if we are looking into a dig into a particular area of research. Another way of looking into this is like going to each patent office website. When I say that going to each patent office website is, as I already mentioned, patent is a territorial right. So when it is being published by different patent offices from different countries, one can go and download those patents and go through them. But it will not be giving me a comprehensive picture about the patent trends and of the patents being published across the world. So this way of doing this would require a humongous amount of man hours, and since it is being done manually, there could be a chance of missing the important data. So we thought there is a very powerful digital database is required with a very good search engine. In this case, we have chosen the artificial intelligence enabled, which is an upcoming area. And thousands of patents, by using this patent search database, we could analyze it in no time. And also the technology trends and what kind of white space analysis is there can be done in a remarkably less time if we are using a digital resource for doing this job. Next slide. So after identifying the need of having the digital database, we have evaluated three digital databases which are existing in the market. Like one is Innovation Q Plus and Derwent Innovation by Clarivate, and then IHS Goldfire from IHS. So for all these three databases, the experts from their domain have come down to the HPGRTC. They have provided the training session, and we have been given the trial access to all our scientists, ranging from 30 days to 45 days of time. And we have done several case studies of our ongoing research problems and have come up with a brief white space analysis identification. After conducting this case studies, we have taken the feedback from our scientists on the ease of utilization of this particular digital databases, and how user friendly it is, and what kind of relevant details it is giving, and how easy to filter the results and go to the actual particular portfolio. So based on the feedback received, we have actually shortlisted IQ Plus as one of the digital database we wanted to go ahead with. And it is now, since last 8 months, we have got this subscription. Right now, all our research, new research project proposals and any ideas are coming up for the patent filing doing this IQ Plus analysis, white space analysis. And that report is thoroughly scrutinized, and then we go through what are the gaps identified by conducting that search, and then that is resulting into a very fruitful project proposal. So when, as I mentioned earlier, the confidentiality is one thing we want to ensure that it is well maintained. So with IQ Plus, we have signed one legal agreement so that whatever our search material is there, it is not out there in the open domain. So as I already mentioned in my next slide, I would be explaining like what are the advantages we have identified with the IQ Plus database. It is a single platform is giving me different patents from different patent offices under one platform, and it has a AI enabled very powerful search engine, which actually gives me more relevant results when I'm searching for a very broad research topic, and it has a translated foreign language patents. It is not a mere machine translation, and we get a very meaningful outcome of the claims, what has been published in a foreign language, and we can make more sense out of it. And then main objective of conducting the all this white space analysis or a patent landscape is to know what are the key research areas being worked upon and what kind of patent trends we are observing. Who are the major key players in those technology areas? These are all the details we can easily find it out from using this digital database. And it is also helpful in creating a patent portfolio for a specific company. For instance, if we have found one upcoming startup has filed so many patents of late, and we wanted to collaborate and then go towards the commercialization, we want to know what is their IP portfolio strength, which we can easily analyze by using this digital database. So apart from this, it has got interactive semantic map technology and heat maps technology, which is gives very user-friendly features by which I can actually go to the relevant patents out of the initial patent search results. With this, we can effectively conduct the white space or a patent landscape analysis, which can be downloaded into a single Excel sheet. And for further analysis, it would be very easy for a researcher. On top of it, like when I'm doing a search in this search engine, I can actually put an alert that in a particular research area, if there is any new patent is being published, it is immediately will be sent to my mail ID so that I am up to date with whatever the new developments happening in that particular technology domain. Having seen like what are the white space analysis tools available out there, and we have gone with IQ Plus digital database, I would like to share a brief case study which I have done on the portfolio search of catalytic pyrolysis of biomass for a broad research area search. Next slide. So coming to the patent search results mapping, next slide. There are 2,500 results were found using this patent search results from IQ Plus database after initial screening. So manually going through this 2,500 results and finding out which is relevant to our search area and which are like a little remotely connected would be a really manner intensive task. So what we do is like we have semantically mapped this all 2500 results in the next slide. So here you see like there are like a different keywords have popped up, like saying fluidized bed, reforming, and then gasoline, aromatics, paraffins, and lignin, and then preparation of the feedstock. So this out of this 2500 results in the next slide, I wanted to know who are the top 10 patent assignees in this area? Like who are the top 10 actively working companies in this area? So here in this slide, you can see all these 2,500 results were drilled down to only 700 results. So I could see like who are the top companies, Honeywell, Shell, MERD, IFP, ExxonMobil, who are the main companies working in this area very actively. So out of these 700 patents, in my next slide, I wanted to know like who are working into only gasoline as a research area. So I have rounded off gasoline in my earlier slide. Now I see only 26 results are popped out of this 700 results. Well, I could do on all the 2500 results, what are relevant patents for the gasoline production. Just for the demonstration purpose, I have only restricted to the top 10 companies. So here what we see is patents relevant to catalytic biomass pyrolysis targeted towards the gasoline or polyphenols production are drilled down from 2500 results to 26. So these 26 results are most relevant. It can be downloaded into the Excel format and we can go through thoroughly and then find it out what is that differentiating edge we would like to work upon and how we are different from it. This is one way of identifying the competitive edge and what are the patents out there as a prior art in the particular domain of research area in a broad research like a catalytic biomass pyrolysis. In the next slide, I would like to touch upon like a different technical categories mapping, which is actually heart of this total white space analysis or a patent landscape analysis. When I say technical categories mapping, like internationally, there are patent classification codes are given when one patent is being filed. What are these patent classification codes? I'll be explaining in my next slide. Here I have actually plotted top 10 first CPC subclasses versus top 20 assignees or applicants. Here what we see this bubble chart, like a B01D, C01J, like that, different CPC patent subclasses are there. Basically, if I say B01D, it is a universal code which says like this patent is mainly relevant to the apparatus, equipment or a separation in this particular area. Likewise, every patent code has got its own definition. In this particular case, if you see this C10G, that is a cracking of hydrocarbon oils, production of liquid hydrocarbon mixtures by destructive hydrogenation or depolymerization, is actually evolved as a major research area which is being focused by companies like Shell UOP, Shell International Research, and people like Gas Technology Institute, ExxonMobil, Enelotech as a newcomer. These are the people who are majorly working upon this subclass of C10G. This is one technical area where people are focusing. Followed by that, if you see, there is a C10J just next to the C10G, which is actually talking about water gas shift reaction. That means going towards this gasification and then followed by you are making a synthesis gas and then followed by going towards a hydrogen or going towards the chemical route. There is definitely a patent activity existing over there, but comparatively less activity is going on. So by doing a detailed mapping of CPC subclass, one could know what are the main technology areas people are focusing upon, and what are that spares areas are available. And as I said earlier, we can actually as a researcher give an explanation why it is happening that way. Going to the next slide, putting up the CPC subclasses by enforceability is another way of analyzing the data. Here what I have done is top 10 first subclasses I have mapped against the number of documents available. Here I would like to bring your focus towards this orange portion is existing, which is basically looking at abandoned or a revoked, seized kind of patents. For instance, one way of looking at this data, if someone is not really focusing down the line, their patents are being revoked or abandoned and there are no action is being taken against it, that means there is a less interest is happening around that area. So that is one way of looking into that data. In this particular case, if you see that there are still a number of active patent areas in a different patent subclasses are still alive all across these years. Going to the next slide. Another way of another input we can derive from this patent landscape analysis is the competitor mapping. As I said, competitive edge is also one of the focus areas for us. So in this next slide, you can see that a number of documents against the top 20 current assignee, that means who is holding the patents, if I have mapped that, as an obvious outcomer, you can see Honeywell and Shell are the major companies. MERDINC is nothing but it has been taken over by the Kyor, who actually went up to the level of commercialization and have produced some oil and put up the produced a commercial level, made an effort to produce a commercial level oils. And if you see in this line, Enelotech, Gas Technology Institutes and Ensign, these are the people who are actually coming up very recently. How do I know that? If I do the same mapping along with the year of filing, we could find out that information as well. And as I said, year of publication, year trend is also important. Here you see there is a star marks of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. It is nothing but here I have taken only the 5 relevance. It is a relevance ranking is another feature which is provided by this tool. For instance, if it is a 5-star ranking, means it is almost 80 to 100%. It is matching with our search criteria. So those results are very close by to our research area. So here I have tried tried to plot all across the last 20 years how this patent activity is being picked up. Here, as we can see, from 2007-8 till now, there is a kind of an upward trend, and now it is kind of reaching the plateau. And 2021 data is not yet updated. That is why it is showing the small number over here. And next slide, I have put up this current assignee with publication year. Like as I said, like you can see who is like recently came into the this research area. Here you see that Analytech is in 1 year has filed a very good amount of patents. Likewise, it is still having a quite a significant portion out of the patents filed each year. So it is a new entrant, but doing quite well in this area. And apart from that, Honeywell has this green portion. You can see that has actually occupied a major portion right from 2011 till 2016. Still it is filing some patents, but it is like coming down significantly. And another feature is the geographic patent mapping, what we could identify from this patent landscape analysis. This is like in this particular slide, what we can see is the country of origin of this particular applicant. Like major portion is being dominated by the United States of America out of those 2,500 records, whatever we have found. 1386 are originating from United States of America. And apart from USA, like what we can see here, like Germany has also quite a good number of patents. France, like EU countries have a good share in this one. And India, it is having around 24 patents and relevant to this particular research topic in this particular area. This is another way of representing data in this slide, like you have a US patents and WIPO applications and US applications. That applications is a still filed status. US patents is which is already granted. So if you see from 2005 onwards, it has the activity has quite picked up in the last 20 years. Quite a good amount of patents have been filed in this area. So on a whole, a summary, using this small case study, what we could conclude is like using semantic mapping, patents can be easily subcategorized or filtered. What we have found, like for instance, for pyrolysis of biomass aimed towards gasoline or olefins, out of that top 10, only 26 are relevant. I could extend the search for the complete data set also, as I have mentioned. And instead of large volume of patents, going through a very condensed version, which are most relevant to your own area, will help the researcher to bring the gap analysis in a no time and come up with a technical differentiator when compared to the prior art existing out there. And we have also seen the CPC subclass mapping and top technical areas being worked out in this particular area is C10G, which is a cracking of hydrocarbon oils, production of liquid hydrocarbon mixtures by destructive hydrogenation and depolymerization. Further, using the filters, only relevant to one CPC subclass patents are also can be analyzed. For instance, I want to go more in depth of the C10G class patents. What are the major aspects people have focused on to it? That is also possible by using this tool. We could do that analysis. And we have found that there are top competitors in this area are like Shell and Honeywell. And new players are coming like Analytech and BASF who are working mainly in the catalysis area. Geographically, we have seen that more patenting activity is happening in US followed by Europe. And then we have some good amount of activity is happening in India as well. So on a total, the best practices what we have found after implementation of this innovation pathway of IQ plus analysis for doing the white space analysis. Right now we are as part of project selection matrix related to patentability and novelty. For every new project proposal, we are thoroughly going through this IQ plus analysis for that particular research area and using very efficiently to identify major technology focus areas. And we are able to do accelerated in-depth analysis of patents for gap identification and finding our own competitive edge of our own proposal versus the prior art existing over there. And also, we are using for incremental innovation possibility finding out, and identification of future potential research areas is another key outcome by utilizing this tool. On a whole, it avoids the duplication of work, and it is actually accelerates the in-depth analysis of the patents and brings in the novelty aspect that can be focused by research scientists in no time. With this, I would like to conclude my presentation. Again, I would like to thank Team Parikkal for giving me this opportunity to present our work in the prestigious platform of DG Sitare. And I would like to thank my supervisor, Mr. Pramod Kumar, for mentoring during this implementation process. And also, I would like to thank Mr. B. Ramchandra, sir, GM R&D, and Mr. Bharthan, sir, head R&D, for their continuous mentoring and support for successful implementation of this tool. And a successful utilization by all researchers is being done. With that, I will conclude. Thank you very much for your patience here.
Thank you, Ms. Lavanya Misala.